Hey guys, so today we will not be doing a tutorial, instead we'll be doing a demo. So I'm going to show you how to make, basically design and model a basic shock on Cinema 4D using all the concepts and tools I've already introduced to you in the previous tutorials. So you can follow along with me if you would like, or you could just sit back and simply just watch, but in the end, when we're done, it should look like this. So basically gonna try to create a shock that looks kind of like this. Now I've done this a few times. In fact, this shock is usually, one of the most common things I like to design on Cinema 4D. So I'm gonna go ahead and let's get started. So, first off, we create a cube, and I'm just going to drag this up so that this horizontal plane doesn't really get in the way. And what we're going to do next is we're going to make it editable. Click that button. We're going to click on this button. That's the polygons or the individual faces button. And we are going to select the side. We're gonna click on the select tool, gonna select the side, and we are just going to move the side to the left to basically narrow the length of this side. And we're going to actually, it will be better if we were to just scale this side instead. Okay, so it will be better if we just click, we basically just scale down the cube as a whole. So I'm gonna go back to this button right here, click on the cube button, then click on the scale tool. We're just gonna narrow the length of this side. To do that, we'll just click on this red square and we're gonna be able to narrow this side. Basically just scale this side down. And we want the size, basically the size of this X side of the shape to be 30 centimeters. I usually make it at 30 centimeters. So just go down here to size and type in 30 centimeters and then press enter. And you should have basically a square that is 30 centimeters thick. Now we're going to treat this as the backside and this as the front side. So first off, we're going to select the polygons button. As you can see, we already have this face selected because of from earlier, but I'm going to show you how to select faces one more time. You just go to the selection tool. You select this face. Then you're going to we're going to extrude it outwards. So to do that, we can either go to mesh, create tools, and then click on the extrude tool, or we can use the shortcut key, which is D. And so then I press D, I have the extrude tool, I click on this side, I drag it out, basically extrude it outwards. And then I'm going to click on the scale tool and I'm going to narrow this down. And then I press D again to extrude out this side that has been narrowed. Next, I'm going to go to my select tool, select the upper and the lower sides of the middle shape that's been extruded outwards from the narrow base. I'm going to press D again. I'm gonna click on this side and extrude and drag my mouse upwards so that this side is extruded upwards. Now this side down here has been extruded downwards instead of upwards. When you extrude multiple sides, they both extrude inwards or outwards. They both don't extrude in the same direction. This side is here, so it extrudes outward or upward. This side is on the bottom, so it could extrude outward or downwards. Next, we're going to simply drag both these shapes to the right. And as you can see, we have somewhat created a tail. Now, perhaps we've extruded this a little bit too much out. So I'm going to undo that, and I'm going to extrude it just a little bit outwards this time, just a little bit shorter. Maybe this height looks good. And you can adjust the how much you extrude these sides out at what length is most comfortable to you. So now we've created the tail, now we're going to do the front side. So first we're going to make the body. So we go to the knife selection tool, we select this side, the front side, and we're going to create 9 segments, each of length 30 centimeters. So how we're going to do that is we're going to, you see it right here, the front side is at X position, negative 15 centimeters. If we want each side to be, each segment to be 30 centimeters, the next segment should end at 15 centimeters so that the length of the next segment is 30 centimeters. So we press D, the extrude tool, and then we extrude it outwards. Oh yes, as you can see, this we're actually going in the negative direction. So this would increase in its negativity, so that if we want the length to be 30 centimeters, we should change this to negative 45 centimeters instead. Now then it is still 30 centimeters. Now, I think I mentioned this in the previous tutorial, but when you're extruding out, you want to set it to a certain position to be extruded to. First, you have to get to the extrude tool, and you have to click on the surface you want to extrude it, and just extrude it out just a little bit so that the software knows that you want to extrude the tool, and then you set the position. Because if you just set the position without extruding it, the software will think you want to basically extend the end of the segment, the same segment to that. So if I press negative 105 centimeters without extruding it, you see that this entire segment goes to 105 centimeters. It doesn't extrude or divide itself up into like 30 centimeter extrusion segments because I have not extruded it. So if I want to extrude this surface to 105 centimeters, negative 105 centimeters, I have to first click on it, then extrude it at least a little bit so the software knows I want to extrude it, and then enter negative 105 centimeters. Right. So we're going to do this 5 more times because we want 9 segments. So this will end at negative 135. This will end at negative 165. Let's see, we have 6 so far. This will end at 95. This will end at 225. And this, the last one will end at, you probably guessed it already, you're probably correct, negative 255 centimeters. Now we have 9 segments, each of length 30 centimeters. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to extrude the upper and lower portions of each segment upwards. Basically each segment until the middle segment, 20 segments more than the previous segment. So I'm going to show you what I mean by that. It's sometimes easier to demonstrate than to just explain. So we're going to go to the Select tool. We select the top and bottom portions of both of the first and last segments. So we select the top and lower portions of this segment and the top and lower portions of this segment. And once again, to select multiple segments, after you select the first segment, you have to press down Shift before you click the extra segment, or else only that segment will become selected. So now what we have to do is extrude it. So I press D, I extrude these upwards. By the way, before I do it, I want to see that these are at the Y position. The top is at 200 centimeters, so just extrude it a little bit, but then set the extrusion to 220 centimeters. and where and once again you set it in the size column under the Y coordinate tab. And next thing we do is we extrude these four sides. So we go to the knife selection tool. We select this side. We hold to select multiple sides, we hold down shift and then click on this side. And then hold down shift, click on this side. And once more, shift and then click on this side. So then press D to bring out the extrude tool. We extrude this a little bit upwards, just click and drag your mouse upwards a little bit. We go down to size column and then we change the Y coordinate to 240 centimeters, so that these four sides are extruded 20 centimeters higher, creating a little incline, like basically a little increase in surface, like a smooth surface upwards, and which we're gonna make later. But first off, we're gonna finish doing extruding the top and bottom sides. We're gonna select the top side of this, and then the bottom side of this. Top side of this and the bottom side of this. Press D. Extrude upwards a little bit, set to 260 centimeters. We'll do it once again for these four sides. Actually, we'll do it for all six of these sides. So the middle three, top and bottom segments for the middle three segments. But the top and bottom sides of the middle three segments, excuse me. And then once we have all these sides connected, we press D, extrude them upwards to, instead to 280 centimeters. Press enter. Now we extrude these upwards some more. We extrude it outwards again. Press and drag up. And then we drag these sides to the left. And you see we have created the fins. Now we are going to connect these sides to basically make them smooth. Smooth them out. So how we do that is we go to the edges tool. Click on the edges button. Then go to select. We're going to select this edge first. We're basically going to move it up. We're basically gonna drag this edge up to this edge. Now how we do that, as you can see the when we click on the move tool, you can see that it can move this way, undo, it can move this way, undo that. So basically it can move these two ways are visible, and it can move this way as well. But none of these arrows give us the ability to move it directly up. So to move it directly up, we have to press this angle button, which allows the edge to be moved in both this direction and this direction, or a combination of the two. So we click this right angle button and we just drag it up to this edge. Here we go. Now we click on this edge and do the same. Click on this right angle, drag it up, and there we go. We do the same thing here and the same thing here. Here we do the same thing. We click this edge, drag it up. And this is the part that usually takes the longest, because you have to drag each line up separately, and you have to kind of be precise, or else even the smallest discrepancies can be noticeable. So like, as in this figure, I did not move it upwards enough. That should be better. And we select this side and we do the same thing. There we go. See if anything here was off. Yeah, this part is off. There we go. This part needs to be moved a little more up. There we go. That should be good. Now we do the bottom parts too. Now the reason why we cannot move both this part and this part at the same time is because we're not extruding them, we're moving them. So when we move multiple edges, they are, or faces, they will all move in the same direction. They won't both move outwards. They both move either both upwards or both downwards, and we don't want that. So we have to do them separately. Have to do each edge separately. Now what we can do, because we have extruded each of these segments up to 20 centimeters more than the previous one, we can select, we can select multiple edges that are in basically in the same side. So we can select these four edges. And for this one, we need the blue angle, which allows us to move them both upwards and to the left. Or we can just use this green arrow, which just moves them down. So when we select all of them at the same position, basically all you have to do is drag this green arrow, which allows them to move directly downwards, which is what we want. Just drag it down until all four of them are directly aligned with the top edge of the next. That's a really neat thing you can do. So you can basically select all four edges on the same side, basically like the same side. They all need to be at either the top or bottom and bottom side, and either on the left or right side. And basically you can just drag them, all four of them, down at the same time, and they will all be in the same position once you finish. They will all be directly aligned with the top side of the next, basically directly aligned with the next edge of the next segment. So I'm gonna do it one more time here. Gonna select this edge, we'll select this edge, and I'm going to select this edge. Once again, we have all three of these edges selected. All we have to do is move them downwards so that until these edges become connected to the top edge of the next segment. So we just click the green arrow, which allows them to move only directly downwards or upwards and nowhere else. We just drag it down until they are all in the same position relative to the next segment. So when we're done, you'll see that they are all directly connected to the next to the top edge of the next segment. So yeah, just when you're moving multiple edges like this, they all have to be on the same side, either top or bottom, and most preferably either both on the top right side or top left side, bottom left side or bottom right side. And then you can just move all of them downwards at the same time using just this green arrow. And when you finish, they should all be directly aligned, creating a flat surface. Or you could just do each of them separately. I usually just do each of them separately because I'm kind of used to doing it that way. So now we are going to go back to the face button. We're going to select this button. We're going to press D and extrude it outwards a bit, creating a head. We're going to scale the head down. We're going to scale it down a little bit in the Y direction, a little bit in the X direction. Scale it a little bit down in the Y direction. Maybe extrude it out a little bit more. Oh wait, no, we don't want to extrude it. We want to drag it out. There we go. Drag it out. Drag it out. This much, I think, no, maybe a little bit more. Okay, there we go. And we're going to straighten these edges out. So, gonna go back to the edges tool, click on this edge. We're going to click the red angle button and just drag it upwards. Think that's good. Oh wait, still needs a little bit more. There we go. That is much better. And now we have to do the same for this edge. Drag that downwards. I think that's good. Is it good? Yep, looks good. Okay. Now we're going to create the eyes. How we do that? We go to the shapes and we click and drag it all the way to until our mouse is over the sphere button. Then we let go. And then we're going to create one more sphere. So these are for the left eye and the right eye. Now as you can see, there's a little dotted line here. So that means something must be off. We'll go back to the cube, which really isn't a cube anymore. And yes, that is right, we still got a little bit more. Still got a little bit, as you can see, this it's not directly a line. As you can see, there's still a little bit of space. So what we're going to do, we're going to select this side, we're going to just drag it upwards a little bit more. So, okay, I think that's good. Now let's click over and see how it looks. Well, let's just try to fix it one more time. Let's see if anything's still wrong. Doesn't look like much. Now we just leave it at that. We just leave it at that. I mean, it's pretty much online. You really can't see the difference. So now we're going to make the eye. So first off, I'm going to make Sphere.1, a child of spheres. I'm going to click that, drag it under till, drag it over the sphere, and then let go. So now the Sphere.1 is a child of the spheres. I'm going to click on sphere, I'm going to move that over here. Quick review of parent-child relationship, where you move the parent, you also move the child. And also, we're going to scale sphere, click on scale to and scale it down. When you scale a parent, the child also gets scaled down to a similar percentage. They're both the same size, they both get scaled down to the same size. Now we're going to move the parent sphere. Basically to where we want the right eye of the shark to go. How about right here? That looks good. We're gonna make sure the eye is just outside the shark so that just a teensy tiny bit of it is touching. Then we're gonna click on sphere.1, move it directly across to the other side of the face using only this arrow, which makes it move directly left or right and nowhere else. And then just make sure it's just barely touching the face. And as you can see, we have now created basically our shark. Now we can rename our shape. So we can name this the shark, basically the body of the shark. We can name this the this would be the Y line. This would be the left line. And then we are going to give it a certain color. So as you can see, this is basically an overview of the shark we've created, just showing you the entire body of it. Now we're gonna give the shark a color. Now I usually make it a turquoise color with black eyes, but when I did this tutorial at a meeting earlier this year, we ended up giving the shark like some kind of pinkish color with yellow eyes. Like, don't ask me how, but that's ultimately what we came up with. I'm just going to do what I usually do in this case. I'm going to give the shark a turquoise color. Just double click here to create a material. Go to the color section. Click this box that shows the color. You have a color picker. Move the slider over to here. The turquoise color. And give the shark a little turquoise color. Maybe kind of like this. Yeah, that's great. And just click OK. I do not want any reflectance. And let's give it a glow. Check the box next to glow. Gonna decrease the outer strength to about 142 and inner strength to about 50. Just drag it to the shark. Just click and drag it to the body of the shark where you want the color to go, and you see the entire shark is now, minus the eyes, the entire shark is now turquoise. Double click again to create another material. The color, we're gonna make the eyes black. So no matter what color you have the slider on, the bottom will always be black. So just click on the bottom directly. No reflectance. Well, maybe let's give it some reflectance. And I think that's it. And then we just drag it to the right eye. We drag it up to the shape organizer under right eye. We click it, and you see when the parent is given a material, the child is also given the same material. So by applying the black color to the right eye, we also apply it to the left eye. One last step, we click the render button right here where the movie clip is. And you see that we have created a shark. Now you see that there seems to be little bit of a discrepancy here. It's a little bit of, seems to be a little bit off. Let's see what the problem there is. It doesn't seem to be much of a problem, so I believe that is fine. Okay. So let's see. So let's render it one more time. And as you can see, well, maybe we can rotate a little bit more so we can see more of the entire picture of the shark. So let's render it one more time, movie clip, click it, and you see that we have, there is our shark. So if you look, go back to this picture I showed you at the beginning, they're both kind of similar, except they are at a different angle. Let's see if we can make them as similar as we can. Maybe that's a little too narrow. Let's maybe drag these fins. Drag these fins a little bit more to the left. So we're going to go to the shape tool. We're going to select these six sides, the top and bottom sides of the fins. Move them a little bit more to the left. Oh no, we have. We got to deselect this side. So we. To deselect this side, press Control and then click on this side. Then we can move these just a little bit more to the left. Zoom in a little bit more. Render it. Maybe change the rotation a little bit. So as you can see, is our finished product. It looks pretty similar to this shark, the picture I've shown you. Except there may be a slight difference. If because maybe we made the shot just a little bit taller, and maybe the fins aren't moved backward as much. But it is pretty similar, I would say, to this shot, the pitch I've shown you at the beginning. So there you have it. Using the concepts and tools we've already done, I've already showed you in the early tutorials, we were able to model and design a simple shark in Cinema 4D. So that is all for today. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions, please let me know. I know this demo has been kind of long, but hopefully the next I don't think the next tutorial won't be as long. I think the next tutorial won't be as long as this one. This was just a demo, so this was basically a run-through demo, so that's why it took quite a bit of time. But the next tutorial will be going over two new tools, the Bevel tool and the Matrix Extrude tool, which should only take about half, at most, as half as long as this demo has been. So thank you for being able to get through this entire demo. If you have any questions, please let me know. And that is all for today, guys. Have a great day, and I'll see you later.